The Aroon Indicator and the Aroon Oscillator. Two easy tools to help you follow trends. But are they effective? Let's find out. Hello, traders. Today we're covering the Aroon Indicator and the Aroon Oscillator. Now, the Aroon Indicator is kind of the more common one. It's the one people are more familiar with. So that's what we're going to go into more detail on. That's the one we're going to cover first. The oscillator is sort of secondary, and I'll get into that why. We'll cover that second, so stick around. But the first thing I need you to do, if you're not subscribed, please go hit that subscribe button now and follow along on the journey. All right. So let's take a look at the Aroon Indicator. If you come down here on the chart and you've got this top box here with the lime and the blue lines in there, that is the Aroon Indicator. And so the first thing you notice are the lines. So we've got two lines, the lime green in this situation. You can make the lines whatever color you want. But on this chart, the lime green is what's called the Aroon up line. And then the blue is what's called the Aroon down line. All right, so that's pretty simple. And you need to know that these lines are kind of range bound, and it's in a range if you look all the way over here to the right from 0 to 100, indicating a certain level of strength. So the Aroon Indicator is a trend indicator. It's trying to help you identify a trend and follow that trend as long as you possibly can. It's a very easy indicator to understand. So let's get into the basics, okay? So everybody knows about crossovers, right? When one line crosses over another line, sometimes the people think that that could indicate certain things. As so, the Aroon Indicator does that as well. So the lime green, remember, is the up line and the blue is the down line. So the green is trying to indicate an uptrend. The blue is trying to indicate a downtrend, okay? And the key here is whatever line is up. So if the blue line, if the downtrend line is up, it's trying to signal to you that the trend is going down. Likewise, if the green or the lime green line is up, it's trying to indicate to you that the trend is going to be moving up. Okay, so it's a red, it's showing you strength of the trend, right? So 100 is higher strength than zero. So that's why it kind of works that way. And going back to that crossover I was talking about, some people would look traditionally, I guess, as a crossover of the blue and the green, indicating a trend reversal or an entry point. Okay, so let's try to make all of that a little more clear by looking at the chart. So let's go back. This is a 1 minute chart on the ES. And it is from Friday, January 24th, 2020. So you got a basic line going down here. Let's get rid of this. We don't need that. All right. So we've got the chart here, the 1 minute chart. And as you can see, the trend is slowly working its way down right there. And you can see that. So let's go down to the Aroon Indicator. And the blue line comes up, it crosses over with the lime green line. And that, if you follow that directly up, starts, this was a very good one, almost at the very beginning of that downtrend. Okay, so the blue line's moving up. So that means that the indicator's telling you that the strength of the trend is starting to head down. Okay, since the blue line is the down line. So it goes up, it's telling you that a downtrend is getting stronger. The green line's going down, it's telling you that an uptrend's getting weaker or disappearing. They cross over, and so traditionally, this is somewhere where somebody might look to get low, and then the blue line is up here at the 100 point, signaling the highest strength, so it's telling you that the downtrend should be strong right now, and sure enough, in this situation, it was correct. You can easily see that there. And if we move across, you got the blue line, also known as the down line, up here near the 100 for the majority of this trend. So it does a very good job. And then it starts diving off almost exactly where that trend is, just a little late, but you can't expect these things to be perfect. and then they cross over, but right here we've got the green crossing above the blue, so that should signal that now an uptrend is getting strong, right? So that crossover happens here, and if you took a long there, you would be taking a long at the high, and you would get burned. So definitely be careful about those crossovers. You probably shouldn't take those at all as any kind of meaning of an indicator of entry. Just use the lines to signal to yourself how strong or weak a trend is. That's probably the safe way to go. Use other means to get entries. Maybe you could use the crossover as some sort of confirmation, but you'll probably want to use, you know, whatever you use, support and resistance, trend lines, you know, order flow, whatever it is that you use. That would be the better way to pick entries. So we've got, it touches up here very briefly. That's what's dangerous about this is in a choppy market, it's going to give you these kind of false signals. So you go up, it touches oh so briefly, you think maybe a trend is starting, and then immediately goes back down because there is no trend there. And then, oh, it goes right back up again, and then it goes right back down again. And so you would have got chopped up right there. I'm sorry, but there's not much in this world that helps with a choppy market. Pretty much all indicators fail once that starts happening. If they start whipsawing back and forth, that is just life in the trading world. So let's follow somewhere where it gets a little more interesting. I mean, you miss this downtrend here. The blue line comes up pretty late in that. And then the green line never really makes it down to the bottom. So it's signaling in this situation that it'd be kind of weak. And then you get a crossover here, it comes up and you get a nice strong trend, but again, you're somewhat late to that. So let's go over. This is a good one. So you see both lines are going down at the same time. They are parallel to each other. So a lot of times what that signals is consolidation. So there's your consolidation right there. And you got the two lines going down. They actually started that right at the beginning of that consolidation. So that was actually a pretty good signal in that situation. They come down, the blue line stays down, the green line heads up. And sure enough, you get this little trend here that it would have got you in on. And then as you can see, like it can get difficult to read if the market is not trending strongly in one direction or another. It kind of chops around with the market as you would expect. So where it's good is in a situation like this where it helps you catch a big trend. So you get the crossover here and sure enough, that's about at the very beginning of this big trend. The blue line stays up real strong. The green line's starting to crash. And sure enough, you get this very big, nice trend working all the way down, and then the blue line starts failing. Yeah, so it's signaling you're getting a weaker, the trend's getting weaker right here, and does a very good job on this trend, signaling the beginning and the end. That's kind of like, that's your golden cherry pick scenario right there. I'm just gonna say that that'll happen less often than it will happen though. So be careful and so on and so forth, but you get the idea of what's going to go on here. So you get, again, the blue line comes up, looks pretty strong. Market chops a little bit, but the blue line is pretty resilient staying up. And sure enough, you get that smaller trend coming down. And let's see if we get another consolidation point right in there with these parallel lines, remember? Get the parallel lines, you got the consolidation point. I mean, that's really all you need to know for the Aroon indicator. Like I said, it's very simple to understand. It's very basic. So let's go to the oscillator and see how that works. The oscillator, I gotta be honest, I'm not sure what the point of the oscillator is because it is just showing you what the indicator is showing you. So I don't know if it's trying to help you in some way determine if the indicator is being accurate or not. But basically with the oscillator, it doesn't do it 100% of the time, but what it's designed to do is it's got a zero line, okay? And it's got a negative 100 and a positive 100. So when, you know, it goes 100 above the zero, 100 below the zero. And its idea is if the one line on this chart crosses that zero line, it should be in lockstep with the Aroon crossing over itself. So if the up and down line cross each other, it should be crossing about the zero line right here. And sure enough, you know, back here, it does it. It misses it right at this one, but then, so it hits it right here perfectly here and here. If you can see that here and here, and then it hits it perfectly here and here, but then it misses those, does it again, misses those. And then right here, it pretty much catches that perfectly, and so on and so forth. And so it's kind of the same situation. If the higher the line is above the zero line, the stronger your uptrend should be. And then the lower the line is down here and the longer it stays down, it should be the stronger your downtrend would be. Okay, so this one works. Yeah, maybe that's what the point is. Maybe it's a little bit easier for somebody to understand. When the line goes down, you're looking for the market to go down. And when the line goes up, you're looking for the market to go up. Versus the Aroon, where even the down line, if it goes up, is just signaling that the market's actually strong going down. You get the point. But so maybe it's just your preference of which one you would choose. And then for these consolidation areas, let's take a look at this one here. Consolidation right there. So consolidation areas would be when the line is kind of hanging out in around the zero line. You know, it's not really going strong one way or the other. But like in this this nice little trend here, it's kind of near the line. So I would throw out the oscillator. That's my opinion. And actually, if you want my real opinion, I wouldn't use the Aroon indicator either. I think it's just going to get you in more trouble than it's worth. But if you have problems spotting a trend, then maybe it'll help you. But if you're looking for a large move like that, you can pretty much see it by, you know, here that you're starting to work down. So I don't really know how it's going to help you. I think it's going to get you in more trouble than it's worth. I think that what's really going to happen, and you probably experienced this with many of these traditional indicators, I think what's really going to happen is it's going to give you more false signals than positive. You're going to get into the trend near the end of it. So by the time you recognize that this is like an actual true signal that the trend's on, now you're going to get in about when the trend is over, and you're going to get out, you know, at the wrong time as well. That's trading in general. So maybe that's nothing unique with an indicator. Maybe that's not a problem with an indicator. That's just how trading is. But, that's the Aroon in a nutshell. If you have any questions, let me know. I would suggest checking out some of my order flow videos. I think it's a much better options for signals than this indicator, because all indicators like this are basically hindsight indicators. They can only work with past information. But if you look at some of my videos on, say, Bookmap, I have a NinjaTrader 8 versus Bookmap video. You'll see that it's telling you what's happening immediately, what's happening now, the buy and sell orders that are happening as they happen. Okay, so that's it. If you liked the video, please hit the like button. If you hated the video, if I dashed your dreams by taking a dump on the Aroon indicator, then hit the down like video or leave a nasty comment below. I respond to many, many things, unless you hurt my feelings. And then I'll just cry. Or not. Happy trading, guys. Take care of yourselves.